Yo, what is up everybody? Hope you guys are doing well today. And today I have another off the dome type video, just a one take video where there's no script, but I'm just gonna be talking off the dome of what's in my head. And the topic today is something that actually changed my life. Like back in September, you know, it literally took me from making a little under $10,000 a month to almost six figures a month. I'm not gonna say the numbers and all that, but basically it really took me to a new height and a new level in all areas of my life. And I really think that this can change your life if you actually apply it, right? And it's funny because I actually posted this video on my Instagram a couple of months ago, I believe, and people loved it. Some people even hit me up saying, yo, it changed their life. And I was like, word, that's kind of cool. Anyways, so I guess let's get to the point of what I'm going to talk about today. And today I wanted to really talk about the topic of raising your standards and what happens when you truly raise your standards and really start, you know, operating at a higher level or a higher standard. Okay, so in September, certain things happened that really made me raise my standards as my friends started crushing it, right? As my friends started crushing it, I realized that my potential, like, you know, if he's making that much, I should at least be making, you know, at least, like, let's just for the simplicity of the video, if someone's making $1 million a month, right, you're like, okay, $100,000, like, that's not that hard if my boy's making, you know, $1 million a month, right? So that happened, and basically I just raised my standards for everything. You know, I'm like, you know what, screw this, I'm not willing to accept, you know, low client results, low monthly retainers. I want to really improve my income, I want to improve my health, I want to improve all areas of my life. And basically I raised my standards, right? And it was crazy because right as I did that, it was crazy, man. I just started attracting just a lot of things into my life, and that was probably the best month of my life financially, happiness wise, fun wise, health wise. That was the best month of my life, and it all happened because I just elevated my standard, you know what I mean? And yeah, I'm telling you this, I've seen this with everybody as well. And an analogy I want to give is me in high school. I was a very, very nerdy kid, and I always would want to get 100% on an exam, 100% on a test, 100% on any assignment, right? And overall, that always didn't happen. But basically, me always aiming for 100 allowed me to get 95s, you know, 89s, sometimes 100. And I say that to say this because it's something crazy. There's something about, like, having a standard. And in your mind, like, mentally, like, if you know that you're not gonna go, like, you know, if your standard is here, let's just say for the simplicity of the video, $10,000 a month, you're not gonna go lower than that, man. You're not gonna go lower than, like, in your head, you'll do anything to prevent yourself from going lower than $10,000 a month. And that is with everything, right? And that's why even me in high school, my bars were so high that, you know, even if I didn't hit it, it's higher than what most people did. So in class, I didn't always get hundreds, but I got 99s, 95s, right? Everybody else in class is getting a 70, a 80, a 60. And the thing is, their standard is low. My standard is high. My standard is 1,000, you know, 100, right? That's why I was able to succeed. And I've seen this with me, like, financially, health-wise, everything is, like, really set yourself some unreal standards, man. It's crazy because, you know, there's even a quote that gets thrown around is, you know, if you aim for the star, you might at least, you know, it's better to aim for the star than the moon, because if you aim for the star, you might actually land in the moon. But if you aim for the moon, you know, you might just take off, type thing, right? So it's like basically saying that, you know, I'm gonna give a number analogy now. So it's better to aim for $20,000 a month versus $10,000 a month, because if you do $20,000 a month, you might hit 15. But if you do 10, you know, if you try to aim for $10,000 a month, it's not usually that you might hit 10, right? You might just hit 9, you might hit 8. What's better? You hitting 15,000 but not reaching your goal, or you hitting 8,000 not reaching goal? Definitely more when you have, you know, for the 20,000, right? So I started doing that in all areas of my life. Like, financially, I said, okay, I'm not gonna accept lower than this number ever. I don't wanna see a number lower than this in my bank account. And I'm telling you guys, changed my whole life, changed the way I looked at things. It almost felt like I was also attracting, like, just bigger things, you know what I mean? I started attracting clients that are making me five figures a month now, which had never happened before. I was just getting, you know, sales for my info product business left and right because people were, like, really, really fucking with me. And then that I've never gotten sales like that ever. So there is really something to you raising your standards, and there's really something to you just saying that, okay, I'm not willing to accept lower than this, right? And trust me, guys, when you start doing something like that, it will literally change your life, as you won't accept like bum shit, because you're gonna say in your head, I am not willing to accept lower than something, you know, lower than this. And I'm telling you, your mind's gonna do everything in its power to make sure that you don't break that standard. Because at the end of the day, like, you know, you don't get what you deserve, you get what you tolerate, right? And if you're tolerating bullshit results, if you're tolerating low results, that's what you're gonna get. But if you have high standards and you said, okay, you know what, I'm not gonna tolerate anything lower than this, your mind will literally work overtime just to make sure that you don't, you know, go below that. So there's something to it, man. There's something to it. You know, it's crazy to me, because like even me saying that I attracted bigger clients and I was getting more sales for all businesses and I'm making more money, right, as I raised my standards. You know, I don't know if, you know, I don't really believe in no woo-woo stuff, but basically I just think that when I raised my standards, I just started significantly working harder and significantly working smarter. And that's why I was able to create, you know, generate those results that I did back in September. So I'll tell you, September was the month that really transitioned my whole life. And I've seen this with not only me, but even one of my friend Dave, you know, shout out Dave from CLE Cleveland. But basically Dave, he was telling me a story, and he's like, yeah, you know, at 16 I was making $14,000 a month, and he just kept on going with the story. And I'm like, wait, Dave, you were making $14,000 a month at 16? He's like, yeah, you know, but I went to a private school where there's so many rich people that, you know, that felt like it just felt normal. And that tells you something about it, man. That tells you, like, that's another reason why you should have a, like, really, really, you know, big environment. There's a reason I live downtown, guys. There's a reason I live here. There's a reason, okay? Because everybody that works here, they don't do no bum shit. They are actually making some big moves, right? And that's why it's important for you to have your environment. So, you know, anyone that makes 100,000 here, like in downtown Toronto, wow, good job. You know, like, you're barely gonna survive living downtown. But the thing is, like, that's what I mean. 100,000 in where I grew up, that's like, holy shit, that's the, oh my God, you're a millionaire basically, right? So there's something to also like changing your environment to make sure that you're not, you know, you're not in a place where the standards are low. Like, I moved downtown, so crazy stuff seemed normal to me, okay? So another thing as well, like, my standards are so high that when I first moved into my condo, after a month I said, you know what, like, this feels pretty normal. I feel like, you know, this is supposed to happen. And the reason I said that is because, of course, if I have high standards, of course this is normal to me, right? One day I wanna have a mansion. One day I wanna have a penthouse on 10 York Street right there. But, you know, right now, I was 19 when I got this condo. Of course it was normal to me. I'm like, yeah, you know, this is normal. Like, this is what normal 19 years are supposed to do. And I'm telling you, when you have your standards set like that, there's no way you're gonna fail, because your standards are so high. But also, you can't just be delusional either. You know, of course, set like, when I say realistic, I don't know, like, a lot of people that have never done anything with their life, they'll be like, oh yeah, I wanna be a million, make a million next month. That's kind of stupid. Like, put in something in your range, but also like make it a little bit unrealistic, okay? And I'm telling you guys, I've had this many times in my life where I've set unrealistic goals and really, really went for it and really crushed it, because, you know, I was going for it. So I'm telling you guys, man, there's something to just raising your standards. There's something to just changing your environment, so whatever is normal to you is different, right? So another thing as well is, someone made $100,000 today and another person made $100,000 today. One guy is happy as hell, the other guy is pissed as hell, right? It's what you tolerate, it's what you view as normal, right? This person that made $100,000, his standards are so high that he's mad that he only made $100,000. This guy, you know, he just hit $100,000, maybe that was his goal. You guys get what I mean? Like, whatever is normal to you is what is gonna be your reality. Whatever you tolerate is your reality. A lot of people like work in those corporate buildings right there in Toronto. A lot of people work there. And the thing is, they are smarter than me. They're probably harder workers than me, right? But I make more money, or some of them, not all of them, I make more money than some of them, because, you know what I mean? Like, I don't tolerate, like, you know, some of these guys, like I said, their potential is like millions, but they're literally tolerating a salary. They're tolerating what they're giving, or they're given, right? Like I said, you don't get what you deserve in life. You get what you tolerate, okay? If you are worth $100, but you tolerate $50, you know, if you tolerate $50 type stuff, your life's gonna be like $50. You get what I mean? It's like, at the end of the day, that's just life, right? Like how people treat you as well. Like, and when it comes to standards, I'm not only talking financially. It's like how your friends treat you, the type of people you are around, you know, the type of girls you want to see, the type of food you're eating, like your health, like really raising your standards for everything. And this is something I've been going through again, as I feel like I kind of faded away, but I'm really back, just trying to raise my standards even more, just try to aim for higher things. And at the end of the day, man, like, I just want to do some crazy, crazy stuff in this world. And I understand that you can't do it with low standards, and you can't do it tolerating some low level stuff. So I don't know, I can go on with this video, and I feel like, you know, at the end of the day, the point is gonna be back to raise your standards. But I think you guys got the point. I think I put my point across of really just raising your standards, really being someone that doesn't accept lower than what they're worth. And I'm telling you guys, it's gonna change your life. Like, start doing that. You know, if your goal per month is 15,000, make it 30. You might hit 20, right? Going hard to get 30, but that's better than 15. Right? So I'm telling you guys, man, just raise your standards, set unrealistic goals to a point. You know, don't say I'm gonna make $1 billion tomorrow like a stupid motherfucker. Don't be delusional either. But, you know, just start raising your standards, man. Not only money-wise, everything, you know, how you're gonna let people tolerate you, what type of food you're gonna put into your body, what your health is gonna look like, right? Everything, like, raise your standards, and trust me, everything will change. And yeah, that is it for this video. You know, it was Off the Dome, one take. I just went on a little rant. I can go on for a little longer, but I feel like I'm gonna leave you guys at that. But hope you guys enjoyed this video, man. I've been loving making these videos. You guys don't understand. YouTube, one day, you know, one day video once per day is pretty hard, but I love doing it. I love the feedback. If you guys watched it till the end, comment the word red. If you watched it till the end, comment the word red, and trust me, man, if you comment red, I just shows me that, you know, you fuck with me, and I really fuck with you as well. And yeah, I just want to grow together. 2020 is the year of growth. Even though this coronavirus is going on, even though we're in quarantine, let's grow together. We can do a lot of big things, you know, collaborating, big things, just working together and just elevating together. So yeah, I'm excited for you guys' growth. You know, hope you guys have a great day. Like, comment, subscribe. Hey, it's your choice. You know, I'm not going to force you to do it. It's your choice. But anyway, hope you guys have a great day. I'm about to go look at my sunset. You know what? Just as a bonus, I'm going to start this video off with my sunset. For everybody that's been wondering what my... You know, let me show you guys my view actually a little bit before we even go. Since it's a one type dome video. So first, oh my God, the sun is shining on me. Right? I almost dropped my camera there. But this is my view. It does know that the sun is like really messing it up, but I think you guys can tell I have a pretty cool view. Got a view of the gardener right there as well, and the arena, that's where the Raptors play or used to play before this quarantine. And this view is unreal, but I'm gonna film it in sunset.